Took his Dundee United side to Pittodrie, hoping to lift the club from the foot of the table with a win over Aberdeen. The home side too were looking to reverse a recent run of poor results, and the team was boosted by the return of captain Russell Anderson and Jamie Smith, both of whom had recovered from injury.
They were good looking and back towards Dempsey and Smith and Severin. Aberdeen pinging the ball at pace. Severin might have a go here, and a decent effort from Scott Severin. First sight of goal. Anderson stepped in, sends the ball forward. Mayer away for United. It will come for Lee Miller, and now Jamie Smith. Smith did well, got away from his man nicely. The shot coming in, and the deflection almost took it past the goalkeeper. Almost put it into the net. Corner coming in, Anderson made a good run, Severin made the run, Lee Miller with the shots into the arms of the goalkeeper, and you just wonder if today is set up for Lee Miller to come back and haunt Dundee United. Foster did well, and now Clark, and goal, Darren Mackey across the face of goal. The flag stayed down there. United have hemmed Aberdeen back for just a period, and there's a chance for the opening goal for Proctor. It was a good cross in. Proctor made the late run into the penalty area. It was a good header and a great save from Jamie Langfield. What kind of reply will the home side have to that? Clark. Dempsey, the runs are all very good for Aberdeen up to the penalty area. Then they stop, and the ball coming in, and surely this time for Aberdeen. Barry Nicholson with the shot, and came back out to Darren Mackey. And he had the simplest of tasks to roll the ball into the empty net to put the Dons ahead. Jamie Smith with Aberdeen goal looking for goal number two. Nicholson helped set up the first one. Clark, now he'll have a goal from there. A curling shot and nearly touched in as well. And Aberdeen are looking ever more dangerous. Is there a chance for a second goal here for Aberdeen? Well, the cross wasn't quite to his man. Nicholson might change that. A good drive from Nicholson straight into the defender, McCracken, as Clark shows a bit of it to Proctor, then goes by him, and Clark, a nice ball in and away by Alan Archibald. United under severe pressure here. Dempsey and Nicholson, it's Barry Nicholson. And that is a quite magnificent free kick from Barry Nicholson. And what a way to start the second half, and what a way to score your first goal of the season. Nicholson already has scored from a free kick this half. What can he do this time? Will it come to him? Instead, the shot comes in from Severin, and that was close. Good Willie, good control. Anderson there with him. Good Willie has done well. Anderson still there. Good Willie still there. And the goalkeeper to the rescue for Aberdeen. They've just fallen out of it a wee bit, Aberdeen, in the last 5-10 minutes or so. Dundee United have been forced to come forward. Part of it is Aberdeen sitting back a bit. Dempsey might shoot from there. Dempsey, good save. Smith sends it in, Dempsey with a header, good save by the keeper. Might still come for Severin. He's shaped to hit that one to the top corner. It's a throw-in in good territory. Conway, oh, Conway fell inside the area. It's going to be a penalty kick. Craig Thompson pointed immediately to the spot. So, Barry Robson against Jamie Langfield. And Robson comes out on top. Now you just wonder if Aberdeen might be a wee bit nervous, or whether that will sting them into a reply. Foster sending it in, and that's a good header. And Barry Nicholson with his second goal of the afternoon. Aberdeen waste absolutely no time in restoring their two-goal lead. Have taken a striker off and brought on a midfielder, but now Is it an opportunity for Foster here? Again, it's one-on-one. Foster, flicking it in. The flag up on this near side means it isn't going to count.
It was a good performance. I mean, Dundee United were, you know, they were very well organised, and we had to have patience when we got the break. And as I say, I thought we could actually went on to score more. You know, we've got a penalty against us, which was very debatable. And, you know, it gave them a lift. And luckily enough, we scored a minute later. Otherwise, it could have been a bit dodgy.
Sometimes we've got to say, maybe we're not good enough. And but there's still a long way to go. But I said to these players, if that's the performance we set ourselves, we'll be heading straight to the First Division. And if the players think they're players in there, in the dressing room, then we've got to have a wee reality check again. So, back to work Monday.
There is good news if you're a Dundee United fan today. 17-year-old striker David Goodwillie has signed a 3.5-year contract extension to keep him at the club until May 2010. So there is good news up at Tannadice at the moment. But chaps, another game where the talk after the game wasn't so much about the performance in this case from Aberdeen. It was more about the manager's position as it stands now. And it was actually the comments that he made after the game more than perhaps the performance. John, what do you make of the Bruce
situation? Yeah, I think we saw Craig Bruce looking at a very low time there. I think he was just after a bad defeat. But, I mean, can we get away from the negativity just for a minute and say how well I thought Aberdeen played? I thought they played terrific. And it's not so long ago we were all talking to, in the same way we're talking about Craig, about Jimmy Calderwood. They went to Queen's Park and got beat. And we've had it with every single manager in the SPL. Gordon Strachan at this point last season had a couple of really bad results early in the season, and everybody's talking about him, and he's turned it around.
John, the story is Craig Brewster, and Hugh, I think you spoke to him earlier today. I hope his mood was a lot better than it was right after the game on Saturday.
Yeah, he'd had his meeting with Eddie Thompson, which lasted 90 minutes at Tannadice today. He said what he said. He doesn't deny saying that he wondered if he could turn the situation round. But as John has said, he was spoken to at a vulnerable moment for managers who have just lost an important game, and he was on a downer, but he did say what he said. Now he sees things in a different light, and he believes that he can take the club forward. But he does admit 27 games played, 2 wins, not good enough. And if they fail to beat Falkirk on Saturday, I would fear for him.
John, you're right to highlight the fact that Aberdeen won, of course, and I think a big part of that was Barry Nicholson, because he's becoming an important player for them, isn't he?
He is, and I thought that Aberdeen, they kind of go in and out this season, but Barry Nicholson, since he's moved to from Dunfermline, he hasn't strung it together week after week, but I think he's beginning now to show the player that Jimmy Calderwood and Jimmy Nicholson saw at Dunfermline, and he's starting to really look at a really top quality Aberdeen player.
And the other player who's doing a good job for them is Chris Clark, and his play at the weekend against Dundee United, they found it hard to deal with him, didn't they?
They did, and I think Aberdeen, their passing was good, they played quite an adventurous system, and they really got at Dundee United. I think that they thought Dundee United were fragile and really had a go at them, and I think Jimmy Calderwood and Jimmy Nicholl should take some credit for that as well.
You've got to think, still talking about Aberdeen, you've got to think if Lee Miller can find his striking boots, Aberdeen are going to go in for a good run, aren't they?
Yeah, well, you'd hope so for Aberdeen fans, because they are loyal and they do stick by their side. And it's not 10, 15 years ago, the New Firm were riding high in Scottish football and were challenging for titles. And I don't know if we can get back to that.
Hugh, how big is this game at the weekend? Falkirk just 3 points away from United. They've got to win it, haven't they?
Falkirk lose, they're bottom, and the pressure's on John Hughes, and he'll know that as well. Pressure goes hand in hand. Well, there's no point laughing, John, because if you're bottom of this league
pressure,
and you drop out...
But I know you, but we had this conversation about Morris Malpass, 3 weeks ago, and then they had a couple of good results, and then all of a sudden it's somebody else's turn this week. And I understand what you're saying to you, but that's the nature of the game.
We can't go away and ignore it. You know that there are, for me, 5 teams under pressure. 5 who will be in a dogfight against relegation. And Falkirk and Dundee United are 2 of them. But I do suspect that if Craig doesn't get the result this weekend, there may be another Monday meeting with Eddie Thompson.
So it's going to be a very, very important week for Craig Brewster, despite what maybe may or may not be in the papers on Tuesday morning.
Horrible weekend for him.
Okay.